Let's pretend you've gotten yourself into a serious situation. You've unknowingly pressed a time machine button, and you've been sent back to the past. However, you have no idea where or when the time machine will send you. Given the situation, you may be feeling worried and stressed. But worry no more, because today, I'll help you determine what year you've been sent back to, and perhaps from there, you'll be able to find ways to save yourself. Without further ado, let's begin our trip through time. Let us start at the very beginning. I hope you're aware of what the Big Bang is, because you must first determine whether or not the Big Bang has occurred. Well, I hope it has already happened, because if it hasn't, that means you're stranded somewhere before 13.8 billion years ago, and everything you see would be a little strange. Unfortunately, if the Big Bang hasn't happened yet, I won't be able to help you much. So I can only hope that it has happened. Then the next thing you have to determine is whether or not there's a planet Earth in space. If you don't see anything, it's as if the time machine has sent you back to a point between 13.8 and 4.54 billion years ago. If that's the case, I'm sorry to tell you that you're headed for disaster, unless you somehow manage to find a spacesuit. If, on the other hand, the planet Earth already exists, the next thing you have to figure out is whether you're being swallowed up by molten lava. If yes, the next step is to glance up and see if the Earth has a moon before you run out of breath, or burn to death, whichever comes first. If you see the moon, that signifies you're within a 40 million year window between 4.54 and 4.5 billion years ago. I'm also sorry to tell you again that a protoplanet is set to collide with Earth at some point during this period. So you're going to die brutally no matter what. Yes, it will be quite tragic, but let's say you do see a moon. Well, that's still not good, because it means you're still drowning in lava, but at the very least, you get to see the moon rotate between 4.5 and 3.8 billion years ago. If you're not drowning in lava, then assess your breathing condition. Are you having difficulty breathing, or are you feeling suffocated? If your answer is yes, you are trapped between 3.8 billion years ago and 850 million years ago. And the reason why you couldn't breathe is that there wasn't enough oxygen in the atmosphere then, and the Earth was full of carbon dioxide at the time. So if you're not drowning in lava or suffocating too much carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, then that basically means you're at some time after 850 million years ago. Do you spot any animals walking around the area? If you don't see any animals, well, you're between 850 and 530 million years ago. And having nothing with you at this period would be very frustrating. On the other hand, if there are animals, do you see any plants as well? Because if all you see are animals and there are no plants, that means you've been transported back in time between 530 million and 450 million years ago. Although there are animals, I cannot guarantee that it will be a pleasant experience, but at least you have some interesting creatures with you. The next thing to consider is whether or not there are any dinosaurs around you. If there are, I know it will be extremely terrifying, but it also means you're stuck between 232 million and 65 million years ago. So if dinosaurs already existed, do you see any mammals? Well, it's important to remember that mammals and dinosaurs existed alongside each other. So if you don't see any mammals, that means you're unlikely to see any dinosaurs as well. And that leads us to the assumption that you're stuck with the amphibians, who existed roughly before 232 million years ago. If, on the other hand, there are mammals but no existence of dinosaurs, you've arrived at a time after 65 million years. And this brings us to the most essential question. Are there any humans or human-like creatures? Well, if there are other mammals and no human or human-like creature, you're probably sent back 65 million years ago. Are you able to tell which continent you're on? It's important to know which continent you're on, especially since humans arrived in different regions of the world at different times. Humans, for example, did not exist in America until roughly 16,000 years ago, 40,000 years ago in Europe, 46,000 years ago in Australia, 80,000 years ago in Asia, and 250,000 years ago in Africa. If the time machine transported you to Antarctica, while the temperature was warm, you arrived here 15 million years ago. Can you see any other humans there? If you can't, you arrived before 1947. That was the year that the continent's first permanent human base was established. However, if you happen to be on an island, things may be a little more difficult, since it wasn't until roughly 500 CE that humans arrived on an island, like in Madagascar. Likewise, there were no humans in Iceland until the late 9th century. No humans in Hawaii until approximately 900 BC, and no humans in New Zealand until after the year 1200. That is to say, you're sometime between 65 million years ago and any of these times, given that you don't see any humans. If there are people on the continent you're on, figure out whether you're seeing solely Homo sapiens, Neanderthals, or a mix of human species. If all you see are Neanderthals and no humans, you're anywhere between 250,000 and 200,000 BCE. And because you're trapped with them, you might as well enjoy your time with them. If, on the other hand, people and Neanderthals or any human species coexist on the continent, you're somewhere between 200,000 and 250,000 BCE. That's the time when Neanderthals became extinct. However, if you are transported to Papua New Guinea, you may have survived there until 15,000 years ago, since the Denisovan human population lasted up until around then. If you happen to come across humans who resemble modern humans, you must determine whether they are behaving normally. Take for instance, do you see signs of cultural funerals? Or do you find yourself understanding their language? If your answer is no, you're still stuck between 200,000 and 50,000 BCE, and the only difference is that you haven't encountered Neanderthals yet. How about when you see humans who are actually acting normally? Then yes, that could mean you're at a time after 50,000 BCE. You might as well learn about astronomy, because it can be beneficial to you. It is important to note that the Big Dipper in the North and Southern Cross in the South are the brightest and easiest to find constellations. Why are these constellations the brightest? Well, that's because the stars that compare them are closer to Earth, making their movements more visible over time. Depending on which hemisphere you time travel to, these constellations could be in one of these three positions you're seeing on screen. Try to determine which of these three positions is the most similar to what you're seeing when you look at the night sky. If the Big Dipper and Southern Cross are positioned as in the first choice, you are at approximately 50,000 BCE. If it is the second option, then you have been transported at a time around 25 BCE. And if it's the third option, then you're in the modern era. If you happen to be in the modern era, have you noticed any indication of these humans' ways of life? Are they into farming, or do they still depend on hunting and gathering? If humans survive by means of just hunting and gathering, then you're probably stuck between 25,000 and 10,500 BCE. It may be yesterday on North Sentinel Island, where there are still uncontacted hunter-gatherers. If individuals already know how to farm though, determining where you are can be a little more difficult. This is due to the fact that farming was developed in different places of the world and at different times. For instance, if you're in the Middle East and there is farming, that means you're at post 10,500 BCE. You're at post 9,000 BCE if there are also domestic sheep, while you're at post 8,500 BCE if you see any cattle. If you're in China and there's farming, you're most likely around 8,000 BCE. You're at somewhere around 7,000 BCE if you're in India, after 6,700 BCE if you are in Mesoamerica, and it isn't until roughly 4,500 BCE if you're in Europe. Aside from farming, Are people riding on horses? If they don't, that means you're at some time before 4000 BCE. And you're after that time, on the other hand, if they are. Are people already using wheels? If they do, you're somewhere around 3500 BCE. Another way to consider is whether there is any evidence of writing, as this would help you figure out what year you're in. Around 3100 BCE, writing was invented in the Middle East and Egypt. Around 2000 BCE in China, and by 650 BCE in Mesoamerica. So if there is any evidence that people knew writing, then you're most likely trapped around these dates. It's also important to look at the alphabets that people use, as they all formed at different times. The ancient Phoenician alphabet, for example, was created approximately 1200 BCE. Around 600 BCE, the Aramaic alphabet was created, which was followed by the Arabic script around 100 CE. Furthermore, the Greek alphabet, which first appeared around 700 BCE, influenced the Latin script that we are familiar with around 600 BCE. In Britain, it's worth noting that the Anglo-Saxons did not begin utilizing Latin script until the 6th century. That is to say, if you don't see any Latin, you are at a different point in time. Lastly, the Cyrillic alphabet was not formed until the 9th century in Bulgaria. Thus, if you don't find any Cyrillic in Eastern Europe, you're most likely in a period before it came into existence. If these alphabets are present, the next question is whether or not people write them on paper. In China, the paper was not invented until roughly 100 BCE. That means the time machine has taken you back before that time, if you were unable to see any paper. Another thing to look at is whether or not people use gunpowder in their weapons. It wasn't until the 9th century in China that gunpowder was invented, and it wasn't utilized in warfare until the year 900. So if you see guns or cannons being utilized, you are at a point in time after this period. In addition to alphabets and writing, you should look and see if there are any handwritten scrolls or books, as well as printed writings. The writing press and mass-produced books were not invented until 1439 in Germany. So if you see any printed book or script, you're at post 1439, which is great since there is a chance that you can just ask someone what year you're in. If you're an average English speaker, you'll probably be able to comprehend what people are saying in England in any year after 1500, although it might still be difficult at some point. It was until the end of the 17th century that the English language we know today became fully established in England. You can see the transformation of the language by tracking the changes in renowned Lord's Prayer from 1690 to present. You might be able to understand early modern English, however, between 1450 and 1690. It was only slightly different. Because of this, we can say that as long as you're in England and can speak English, you can ask someone what year it is and get an answer if you're at the time after 1500. But any time before 1450, the words would be incoherent gibberish from most modern English speakers. To understand more of this, take a look at the Lord's Prayer in Middle English between 1066, as well as the version in Old English before 1066. You'll notice how the English language changes over time, and how it was so different back then. That means if you can't understand anyone in England, you were sent back to a time before 1500. And if you can communicate with people in English effectively, you can just ask what year it is, and you'll hopefully figure out how to return to present time from there. I do hope you don't manage to live in an ice age or be stranded with the dinosaurs. If you enjoyed this video, click like, please subscribe, and click the bell to be notified when new videos are posted. And as always, thanks for watching.